Welcome, Tejano fans. I am so glad that I get to hang out with you for the next half hour. This episode is going to be fierce and very extra. We have next-gen Tejano artist Eric Lee and my personal favorite artist, Stefani Montiel. So let's get right to the nitty-gritty with Alicio and multiple Tejano Music Award winner and six-time Grammy nominee, La Dueña, Stefani Montiel.
Hello everyone, I'm Alicio Leal with TMA TV, and today I'm with Stefani Montiel. Hi Stefani.
What's up, Alicio?
Thanks for coming out today. I'm so glad you're here.
Thank you so much for having me. I've been waiting to come on, so I'm very excited, and thank you guys, and thanks to everyone out there watching.
Well, I've been asking for you for a long time, so you're finally here, so thank you for that. So I want to say that I really appreciate you being here, because you're like one of the hardest working artists. Now, the folks that don't know my past, I used to do a lot of radio and marketing, and you were always there and down for me to do different things because you like to engage with your fans and, you know, you're always trying to market yourself. That's fantastic. Tell me, why do you love your fans so much?
You know, I've been in this industry a long time, close to 30 years, and that's kind of, you know, crazy thinking about how long I've been in this industry. But it really is all about the fans out there. You know, I wouldn't be able to sustain in this industry, especially coming from outside of the state of Texas. You know, it's difficult enough just to be an artist in Texas where you're at home, but, you know, coming from another state and having to basically start all over and, you know, just start a career, you know, from the ground up, you know, I wouldn't be able to do that without all of the fans out there. So I, you know, I'm very thankful to everyone out there that supported me throughout the years, and I just love you guys. I try to engage as much as possible. I get very close to my fans. I love them very dearly, and most of them are more like family and close friends than just fans.
Yeah, well, you know, typically when I'm interviewing someone, I'll do a couple pieces of research, and you know, there'll be a couple hyperlinks. You have so much out there. If you Google Stefani, there's so much out there. You're like all over. So that just speaks tremendous to the effort that you're putting towards your career. So congratulations on that. So skip ahead. COVID hits, all the way to 2020, okay? Everybody's down and out. You're hustling. You have the number one song of the year for 2020. That's amazing, congratulations. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, well, you know, I think all of us had to get creative at that point, especially, you know, the music industry, the entertainment industry. You know, we had released that song, Extraño Tu Amor, around that time, you know, the beginning of the year. Mm-hmm. And I think, you know, that song just really hit home for a lot of people because we lost so many people,
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
during that first
sure,
year with
sure.
everything that was going on. And a lot of people just really felt this song. They felt it, you know, in their soul because they connected with it so deeply, you know, losing someone. And so that song just did really
the timing
well.
Was just impeccable on that, huh? So you had the number one song for 2020. Then you have another one that comes around in 2021 that's number one for several weeks with Ya Lo Ves. Tell me about that song.
You know, I it's very rare when I hear a song in demo form that I'm just like, oh my god, I love it. You know, like it, sometimes Gabe will be like, well, listen, you know, let me arrange it for you, and you know, it's gonna sound different when I do it. But when I heard Ya Lo Ves, it was just, I felt that song. I felt it so deeply, and I connected with it. You know, just on a level of, you know, we all go through things with relationships,
mm-hmm.
and you know,
not me, nah.
We feel like we're not gonna make it through, or we can't make it through without them. And you know, there's sometimes we need that encouragement, and this song just gave that. It gave that encouragement to say you're gonna be okay, and you know, look at me now, I made it through, and I'm just fine. You know, and,
yeah.
and I think that's, you know, we need to hear that sometimes because we don't always you know, think we can. And so this song is just that song that kind of gave so many of us a push that said, you know what, you're gonna be all right no matter what. So
speaking of bigger and better, here come 22. Okay, that's on that. You had the number one song again for a few weeks. What's going on? Okay, we're gonna call
yes.
you Miss Number One. That's your name.
No, it's been crazy. It's, you know, we've had a string of number ones, and it's, you know, I just attribute it to great music. We take our time. You know, we don't sit there and just throw out music just because we need a song now.
Well, it's fantastic. Your music is awesome and unique. It always has a driving beat and is like shots. Oh, I love shots. I remember, anyways, I will tell you that story, but let's just say it was a good time. It was fun. So, okay. So part of the commercial success for an artist is endorsements. So you've had Ford And now you've got Hercules Music Stands. Tell me about that.
Yeah, that was really amazing. You know, and Ford found us online. They just kind of sent us a message and they told us they were interested in working with us. And so
wow.
We did a huge promotion with them.
I hope they Google us.
I know. I'm going to tell them.
All right.
And then Hercules Stands, yeah, that kind of came about with a production company that we're working with out of Nashville. Called La Cara Productions.
Okay.
And they kind of, you know, helped us out with that. And Hercules was interested in working with a Latin artist. And I believe I'm the first Tejano artist that they've ever worked with before.
Hey, congratulations on that. Hey, trailblazer.
Yeah, and so, it's amazing. There's so many opportunities out there for, you know, for all of us, for Tejano music artists and musicians, songwriters. And, you know, what I love about this is you know, that these stands are universal. They're global. This is a global company, and I'm just so excited to be part of them. And, you know, we use our stands all the time. My keyboard players, drummers, everybody. I have, of course, my stand. And, you know, it's just...
I can't stand it either.
But, you know, I have to commend you, Elicio, and all the team here at TMA TV. I just want to say thank you for what you guys are doing for our industry, because this was deeply needed. And, you know, it's so nice to see that you guys are catering to the next gen of Tejano music fans, because there are a lot of Tejano music fans out there that are younger and they don't have an outlet. So I think that this is the perfect outlet for that. And, you know, to all of you out there that are watching, make sure you tell everyone about it, because, you know, just like any of us in anything we do, we need support. So you guys need to support the show. Make sure you tell
all your friends
about it, all your family, everyone, because this show is for y'all out there. So kudos.
I appreciate it with all my heart. Thank you very much. And this has been a passion project. I've actually been thinking about this for years and years and years. I told Gabriel about 10 years ago on a text. I said, I don't know when, bro, but we're going to work together, man. I said, it's happening. Just give me time. Formulate some stuff, and then, you know, so it took some time, but quite honestly, I appreciate the kudos. I did the show, and I asked Gabriel to help me with the show, and we talked to the TTMA guys about the show for our grandkids, for my grandkids. That was the incentive. I have grandkids now, and I'll be darned if I'm gonna be the one that could have changed things and did it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So that's kind of who I am as a person. So I seen the opportunity and I says, I'm gonna do this. So thank you very much for
great
that.
Job.
Thank you.
Job.
Appreciate it. Well, again, thank you for your time. Final words. What would you like to say to your fans? Say to your family? Say to anybody you want? What would you want to say?
Always thank you. Thank you so much. So much gratitude for always supporting me and my music, my family. You know, we cannot do this without every single one of you out there that listens to our music, that buys our music, downloads our music, comes to our shows. And we do it willingly because, you know, what we do is for you guys. It's for every single one of you out there that loves music, that connects with our music. And I'm just so appreciative for every one of you for supporting us for so many years. And to all my family out there, I love you guys so very much. And you're the reason why I sing.
All right, well, you're gonna dance with me, right? I'm gonna hold you to that.
Okay,
all right.
I need to give me some cowboy boots because these babies
I
can't do that.
Yeah, I can dance in chocolates, girl. I got skills. It don't matter what we're dancing. All right, well, I appreciate your time. Everyone, this is Elicio Leal with TMA TV. This has been Stefani Montiel. It's been a pleasure. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Elicio. Thank you, TMA TV.
Back to the studios.
Great job, Elicio, and thank you to the very talented and beautiful Stefani Montiel. Great interview. Now let's check out one of Stefani Montiel's hottest videos, Cumbia Fantasia, right here on TMA TV. cool video and what a danceable beat. Now let's check out this next clip with Alicia.
Thank you, Leah. Hi, everybody. I'm Alicia Leal with TMA TV. You've probably seen me on TV dancing. Well, guess what? Last week, I went to the New Beer Depot because I wanted to find the next gen Tejano dancers for you. But I'm not a great production guy, as you can tell, right? So, you know, it was a little sketchy, the video. My producer, Gabriel, got on my butt a little bit. So I had to go back, and I had to clean it up. And I'm glad I did because I got some great Tejano dancers. Check it out. Walked in. It was packed as usual. This time, it was DJ Ray in the house.
We got TMA TV in the house tonight with DJ Ray in the house tonight. Here we go.
The music was bumping, the hips were moving, the thighs were shaking. Thing about us is Tejano's beat dance to everything. Country, cumbia, ranchera, we love it all. And guess what? We dance it all. So there I am, looking for my dance partner who never showed up. Puro? Party. Everybody was having a good time. The dancers were moving. And then guess what? TMA TV came on. And at that point, everybody started looking at themselves, trying to see if they could see themselves dance. So then I got an idea. Hey, Leah. Yeah, you, Leah. Are you listening? I got a challenge for you. Are you ready? I'm going to challenge you, Leah, to a dance-off. You get a team of 21 to 30 year olds, and I'm gonna get my classics like these guys. I don't think your team can compete with this. Look at that. Look at how graceful. So, Leah, you and your new generation Tejano dancers are gonna dance against me and my old schoolers.
Después de ti, ya no hay temores que esconder. Y ahora al fin, vine a ganar y no a perder.
Anyways, Leah, I don't think you should be doing that. So, if you want to be on Team Leah, you're 21 to 30 years old and you want to dance on Team Leah against me and my old school folks, send us an email, info@TejanoMusicAwardsTV.com, and put in the subject line dance contest, and then put your age, so we know whether you're going to be on Team Leah, all her young folks that, you know, think they're all that, or me and my classical generation. Yeah, we're gonna throw down old school, bro. Are you down or what? All right, I'm counting on you, man. Yeah, I'm looking for Sergio. Yeah, I already did left a message and a text. All right, hey, tell him to call me back, it's important. Yeah, ¿qué pasó, Chuy? Buscando por tu primo. Hey, bro, you still dance? How much weight have you gained? Yeah, you heard? Yeah, man, I've talked lots of smack to Leah. Hey, Debbie! Oh, she don't live there no more? Who's this? Her great-granddaughter. Hey, ¿qué pasó, primo? Yeah, long time no see, huh? Yeah. No, yeah, I know, Y2K was a long time ago, but you know, yeah, man. Hey, you remember me? No? Yeah, I used to spit. I bought you the drink. Whose dog?
Thank you so much, Alicia. And now it's time to check out Rudy Trevino's Tejano Gold Countdown Top 10 Songs of the Week, right here on TMA TV.
Number 10 this week, Quédate by Magnifico Siete. Con todas las cosas. Number 9, The Crazy Pimps, featuring El Gran Sabor, Cumbia Barulera. Number 8, Roel Martinez with Un Grito Medley. Number 7, Stefani Montiel with Quédate con él. Number 6, Lucky Joe, Hasta la Miel Amarga. Cuando el amor se acaba. Coming in at number 5 this week, Marcos Orozco with Cada Día Más. Voy a quererte cada día. And number 4, Jay and Roxy Perez with Tú y Yo. Number 3, the South Texas Homies with Por Fin Decidí.
Hoy por fin decidí.
Number 2, Texas Latino with Completamente Enamorados. And number 1 this week, Shelly Lares with Porque Tú Eres Mi Cariño.
Props to all the artists that are making huge moves in the Tejano industry. And now it's time to catch up with one of those artists that got his start with Los Desperados. TMA TV is proud to present Tejano pop artist Eric Lee.
Hey everyone, I'm Elisa Leal with TMA TV. I'm here with Eric Lee. What's up? Hey, how you doing,
what's
man?
What's up?
Hey, check it out. Opposite of what everyone says Tejano is, right? Young, good looking, and in shape. Hey,
thank
man.
Thank you so much.
So tell me about yourself, man.
Okay, so my name is Eric Lee. My last name is Villarreal, so I come from the Villarreal family. My dad is from Los Desperados. My uncle is Mike, my dad is Lee, and my other uncle is PJ. And the other band members are basically uncles by association because they've been in the band since before I was born. So they've been in my life, they've been in my life entirely. So
Matt, so let me tell you, you're in good shape.
Thank you.
So working out, is that a family thing? Because what the heck, you guys are all muscles, man.
It actually is. It's my dad used to be a bodybuilder. My uncle Mike really much followed in. I don't think my uncle bodybuild a little at all. And then my other uncle, he pretty much just works out whenever he can. My mom was an aerobics instructor, so I was a cheerleader and a dancer. So kind of being physically fit has just been something that's just in our family. It's just what we do.
Are you gonna have an album cover like your uncle and dad did the Test Tube Babes, where they were like with their shirts off and all their muscles and stuff? Is that your album cover gonna be like that?
I actually am doing a tribute to that.
Are you really?
Yeah, I am.
How about that?
Yeah, I'm gonna recreate it.
Oh, fantastic!
Yeah, I'm gonna recreate
it.
The Test Tube Babes and our old album. I'm gonna recreate it.
Yeah. I love it.
I had to.
Hey, first here on TMA TV, you guys. Hey, so tell the fans a little bit about your music, what you like to do, you know, a little bit about your future.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, so first and foremost, I was singing with Los Desperados, and during the time of the pandemic, I got an idea to do a song to kind of uplift people. That's something I've always liked to do in my performance. If I could just get one person to smile in the crowd and kind of change their night, then I did my job. Contacted Zavala to see if we could do a single. And it was, we didn't have a name for it, but I told him that I wanted something uplifting, something very nice, and something to kind of get people distracted from what was going on. I think I had 2 recording sessions, and on the second one I said, hey, so what do you think about turning this into an EP? So it went from one song to 5.
So what's an EP?
An EP is like a smaller version of an album, or maybe I could just call it a mini album. It's 5 songs.
Okay.
Yeah, you got Toda la Noche, you got Work, you got Coconut, a Wasabi, and Alone on the Dance Floor. So,
I'm hungry. Go ahead, wasabi.
A lot of them are very themed. A lot of them are very much something that I felt that I just wanted to do for not only myself, but like little Eric Lee. For instance, I have a song that's heavily inspired by like boy bands like NSYNC, Backstreet Boys, K-pop sounding stuff.
Okay.
And I said, Zavala, I want to sound like I'm an NSYNC member. And he's like, okay, let's do it. And I just said, but I wanted it to be a little bit more Latino, not so much straightforward. I wanted to add my own little Eric Lee flair, if you will. So he sent it back, and it was exactly what I wanted. And every single time I would send him stuff of what I wanted for a song, I would say I conceptualized the idea of every song, and I gave him the seed. He just watered it and grew it into the monster that it became. Call it a monster because it is a really, really good EP. It's 5 amazing songs. If you're at a party and y'all need something new to play, play 1 through 5. You will have your night lit. You'll put it on repeat, I guarantee.
Fantastic. Well, you know, you've got a good future ahead of you,
Thank you.
You're a young, bright guy.
Thank you.
I'm sure you got a lot of fans that are gonna, you know, start to come. So tell us about how a new fan base can find you. What's your social?
So I have Instagram, TikTok, and a YouTube channel called Eric Lee TV.
Okay.
And then on my Instagram and TikTok, it's Soy Eric Lee, like the soy sauce, but saying Soy Eric Lee, like I'm Eric Lee.
So you've got this amazing music video called Toda la Noche.
Yes.
Tell me about it.
Okay. So it was produced again by the one and only Gabriel Zavala. And what I just wanted to do was use this music video to almost look like a live performance, if you will. And I wanted to showcase how I would perform. And we collaborated on making it happen. He found the set for me. We got the dancers, we showed up on set, and we filmed the pieces that we needed to film, and then we just put it together, and I think it came out good.
Well, I'm gonna have to get a piece on film of you and Leah dancing.
Oh my God, yes, we actually need to do something.
Yeah, because we are trying to encourage young folks like yourself to get into Tejano dancing, to take it, you know, to the next level, mm-hmm. and really try to outdo my generation.
Yeah,
because yeah. I'm old school Eli. I feel like nobody dances better than us.
Yeah.
So is there anything else that you want to say to your fans? A special thank you? A special somebody you want to say thank you to?
If I could say thank you to one person, it'd be my mom. She has been the biggest help for this entire thing.
Her name.
My
What's
mom,
mama's name?
Gina. Mama Gina.
Hi, Gina, Mama.
She, biggest supporter. So this
moms whole, are great,
they
man.
They are. Like, that's what I'm saying. This entire visual album that I'm doing inside the mind of Eric Lee, it's actually dedicated to her. She's watched it happen from beginning to end, from singing with my dad, practicing before I was in the band, and messing up over and over and over, to joining the band and singing songs good, to then recording my first song with the band, and now having my own album, and now to have my the own visual album. Like, this is dedicated.
So you're mama's boy too then?
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely.
I dedicate my work here on the show to my mom.
Oh,
so
that's
there you
good.
Go.
Okay, yeah.
So there you go, man.
So two mama's
cool.
boys, yeah.
Yeah, man. Hey, it is what it is. Hey, yeah. We get it done, bro.
Yes,
we get it done.
Yes.
We get it done. One of the challenges with a young person like yourself has been breaking through that corporate clutter in terms of media, right? Mm-hmm. The radio stations, you know, they have a certain sound that they want to kind of adhere to. There's not a lot of opportunities for new artists to get music out there and to expose their creativity, mm-hmm. especially if it's off format a little bit, right? Because everybody wants to say what Tejano is.
Uh-huh.
So,
and I'm definitely off format for sure. Like not
we're
even.
We're off format. Okay. But you know, that's done by design. You know, one of the specific goals that Gabriel had in mind and I had in mind for this particular show is to give artists like yourself an opportunity for the exposure, because you're not on the radio, you don't have the love right now from, you know, the big corporate guys. But we love you. We want to get you going because we know that it all starts here at the underground. We're the underground.
Yeah, no, I totally agree with you on that too. And I appreciate this opportunity for being here. It means a lot. Doing what I do, I have so much passion behind it and getting to express it and share with everybody who's interested in watching. It feels really good. So thank you guys so much.
Eric Lee. So Eric Lee is the brand.
Eric Lee is the brand.
All right.
This is the brand right here.
That's the brand. All right, folks. Hey, this is Alicia there with TMA TV, and this is Eric Lee the brand. Good job, brother.
Thank you. Thank
nice
you.
To
thank
meet you,
you
man.
Nice to meet you.
Cuando escucho el tambor se me alegra el corazón, llevo ritmo muy adentro. Esta noche yo me perderé, con el ritmo yo me escaparé. Si me da la gana yo tomaré, y en cada trago me olvidaré. Todo lo malo que está pasando yo voy a vencer. Me gusta gozar la vida. En mi pensamiento, cuando escucho el tambor se me alegra el corazón, llevo ritmo muy adentro. Esta noche yo me perderé, con el ritmo yo me escaparé. Si me da la gana yo fumaré, y con cada soplo me olvidaré.
gusta gozar la vida. Toda la noche disfruta la fiesta. Toda la noche we like to party. Toda la noche move your body. Toda la noche.
Thank you very much for tuning into this episode of TMA TV. We hope that you've been enjoying all the episodes so far. We are doing our very best to bring you the best and brightest stars in La Onda. Show ideas? Contact us at www.TejanoMusicAwardsTV.com. If you'd like to catch up with past episodes, make sure to visit our YouTube channel. Make sure you're subscribed while you're there. I'm your host, Leah Cruz, and I'll see y'all next week. Bye.